Hello. I might be a little quiet. Always do sound checks before you do any of the other stuff. Now let me double check something else here. I hope y'all are getting the noise of the waves. Turn that up just a little bit, because this is quite intense. So I thought let's do a return to basics, a good old fashioned ear cleaning, one that we don't have to stress about, one that we can mutually relax to. Seems kind of like one of the ears is much louder than the others. But it's difficult. Oh, yeah, it's definitely. Which one is this? This is the right one. How's that? And how's that? Oh, much better. Much, much better. Wow. Turn it up just a little to crispify it. There we are. My cables were very cheap, considering the cost of everything else in this setup. It's about time I replaced them. Two of them are bad enough. Do this. I am going to tell you about what's coming up for this channel as we return to basics, just for this one at least. And for me, your boy, Precious. Precious is almost a good trigger word, but I don't have any. Whoa! Sorry. That's way different. If I get really close like this, my eyes are tweaking out on the mic. It's like straight on, and then it's like directly into your ear. And if I used trigger words, almost is not a trigger. this video in the style of one of the delightful Japanese ladies I listen to, Japanese VTubers. Well, she's not really a VTuber because she just does the voice work. She does very, very heavy cleaning. Specifically streaming for 5 months now. As a matter of fact, 5 months and 6 days. A lot has happened over that time. We have gone from like 8 followers on YouTube to 84 at the time of writing this. 5 months. Algorithm actively working against me because I'm a tiny account. That's impressive. I appreciate all of you. And I hope I continue to deliver in the future for you. of things. I love live streaming. I love chatting with people, both in the comments and during streams. I love providing this kind of service. It is a service. I'm not doing this chatting on live. And going forward, I think I might do live streams as a special thing for ASMR. I see a lot of people, especially from Italy, and I do support a number of their VTubers financially with subscriptions. Because I like their ASMR a lot. Imagine supporting like a full-time gaming streamer who just does ASMR like once a week. Because you like their ASMR, but that's what I do. That's what I do. Maybe some of you will be in that position in the future. I don't know. I will tell you, if I could move everything to YouTube, I would. But Twitch is much, much easier. Just say, I'm into women, and so I like hearing women mouth sounds. I do not actually like listening to men mouth sounds, and that's a personal preference. This particular ASMR artist, she likes listening to both. She said any mouth sound is a good mouth sound. So y'all who have found me, y'all who listen to these on the regular, I know there are regular listeners. Y'all, please tell me if you would like me to do mouth sound ASMR videos, or ASMR videos with mouth sounds in them. Because I can learn. Like I learned anticipatory speaking in ASMR. It's like storytelling, but with intentional delays for dramatic effect. Builds the anticipation. Well, friends, I have been trying for a long time on Twitter. Unsuccessful, just like with my music career before, my lack of networking. And it's not for lack of trying, it's just, it sucks trying to network as a baby VTuber when your Twitter has 18 followers and you're trying to network with someone who has 10k followers on Twitter. same place without any conversation in between. Oof. That wasn't the sound I was going for. I wanted the fluffy sound, not the dragging fingers along the stick part sound. Anyway. Anyway. I decided to tone down the streaming, even though I love streaming. In the streams. Let's just be honest. However, crazy enough, I had a little 22-second meme video. Poorly edited. Sound is all over the place, but people thought it was hilarious, and 2,300 views later, YouTube decided to give me some community stats finally. It's like there was a hidden hurdle where YouTube didn't care about you until you've had at least 5,000 views total. I appreciate all of you, because despite all of those views, I only went up like 4 subscribers. And who's to say those subscribers didn't subscribe for the ASMR? YouTube sent me a nice little montage of my week. On Monday, they were like, yeah, look at how awesome you are. Look at all that stuff. Look at those pretty numbers. And I'm like, great. That was the worst meme video I've ever made. Hastily thrown together. It was a good idea. So how do I repeat that, but with better video? Better quality. Improved. And then the next video I drop gets 7 views. You know how it'd be. The video you didn't work on and you just hastily cobbled together over 30 minutes gets all the views, and the video you spent like 12 hours on gets 12 views, one for each hour you worked on it. But I improved through it. Nothing that I've done here is a waste of time. And if you're trying to improve something, nothing you've done is a waste of time. You have learned from your mistakes. You have improved. You are getting better. Keep at it. I believe in you. And I hope you believe in me too. Because, dear friends, it's not all about me. And it's not all about you either. It's about us in the space, relaxing, doing our thing, and making it work. YouTube content. as large as Phase Connect. They are making huge waves. A couple of their talents up 50 to 70,000 subscribers on YouTube. And Rin Penrose is up at like 600,000 or something. She's crazy. But she exploded because she did shorts. Now, if I explode, get bigger, rather, through the shorts, that's a good thing. If I don't, I will have improved my video editing a lot. For example, that first, quote-unquote, funny short is going to drop. It's going to drop on, tomorrow, Saturday. So, glorious friends, you will get a chance to experience a little more of the funny side of Brescia Orion. But it's not super funny. That one, I would consider it like, if I'm generous, a 6. On the funny scale of 10, I consider it a 6 out of 10. So it is slightly above average because of the production quality. The humor itself is not really up there. However, I've got a lot more coming. I have an entire document, one page of a document so far, that is all ideas. Stuff to do for shorts, and I have 2 more recorded. I just need to edit them, and the more shorts I edit, the better I will be at editing, which means the longer videos will take less time, which means more content for you, especially if you also enjoy funny, joking takes on VTubers in general. The VTuber community of Twitter in particular. There are a bunch of new cases on Twitter, if you didn't know. If you are also on Twitter, I'm kind of sorry, and I'm kind of not, because you knew what you were getting into. You absolutely knew what you were getting into. Twitter is crazy, Twitter is wild, but Twitter is free. In several senses of the word, actually, free speech and, free to use while they harvest your data for whatever purposes they're going to use them for. Advertising, whatever. So, it's free with a grain of salt. Free with salt in your brain. With a little salt in the grain, it's pretty good. Pretty good to have a little salt in there, but not too much, you know. Now, Twitter VTuber community, too much salt in the grain. It's ruining it. Totally ruining it. I don't know what they were really thinking. Trying to do VTuber stuff on Twitter, but all the small guys are like Vine, Ark, all sorts of crazy stuff. Behaving badly. They're horny all the time. I don't know what to do about them. I will also say, I liked a cosplayer, a person who puts on costumes of video games or anime characters. I liked her cosplay, right? I might have liked 2 pictures of her cosplay. Her cosplay was safe for work. Suddenly, for the last 2 days, my Twitter feed is full of not safe for work naked people, and I am upset about it. I am actually upset about it. Deeply aggrieved. I can't believe that Twitter would do this to me. Why would you do this, Twitter? Why? If I can channel my inner William Shatner, why? Why would you do this to me, Twitter? Why? Why would did you do this to me? I don't know why they did it to me, but I have been scrolling through Twitter at work, and suddenly there's an hypno and a hoo-ha. And I'm like, please, supervisor, don't look over my shoulder right now. Please, cameras, do not record this on my phone. And yes, there are a lot of cameras in my work. I work at, I'm not going to talk right now. If we get big and I become a streamer full-time, or a content creator full-time, or both, would be nice. I really like both. I will tell you, and then you will ask me for advice on traveling, and I will give it at that time. Oops, I gave it away. Oops, I did it again. Your heart got lost. And now I'm found in something. I don't know what the Britney Spears song was. Anyway, sure why I've been talking kind of randomly and fast, but I think this might be a good trigger for you. Maybe a good trigger. A good trigger for you. Good. Let me know in the comments if it is. That was really fun. Is up, and now I've got to record Monday's video after this. Yes, you are getting fresh pressure on Friday, and on Monday when I do the no talking video, you are getting stale pressure. Just call me pressure is the first name. Scheduled, as you can see on my schedule, which you check every single week. You hang on to every word that's on my schedule because my schedules are awesome and the photo editing is top notch, and you admire my photo skills. And sometime when I do another offer to make memes for you, you will come to that stream and you will suggest a meme, and I will make that meme for you, and you can use it wherever you want. Anybody's like, man, that's a saucy meme. You could be like, hey, this VTuber Marshall Orion makes memes for people. You should go and check out his streams. I mean, you don't have to, because, to be honest, if you're like me and you're listening to an ASMR like this, you are listening to the first 10 minutes, and then you are turning it off, rolling over, and falling to sleep. That's how I work. That's how I operate. I listen to, I don't know, I've got 40 or 50 ASMR artists on my YouTube favorites, subscriptions. That's the word, subscriptions. I have a lot of VTuber and other ASMR artists that I am addicted to, and I listen to them all the time, even at work, and I can sleep at work, and I'm like, dang it, I should stop listening to ASMR at work. So addictive. Anyway, when I go to sleep, I listen to about 10 minutes of certain ASMR artists that I trust with my ears, because I know they have a very good and controlled environment, and they're really good with triggers, or their mouths, making trigger sounds. Should not be in the gutter. Got me. Yes. Good. This one was longer than usual because I am still playing with distance and back and forth. Just really fun. Oh, I might get a desk cam at some point in the future. Both for the crispy sounds that it produces, and so that I can record stuff like doors creaking, doors slamming, cars turning on for future ASMR videos. sense the degeneracy already. I've been on Twitter for too long. Anywho, dear friends, dear listeners, I will catch up with you another time. Just be aware I am working behind the scenes on a lot of things, including I will be borrowing the design from this current Vivoid model, which was free. Things. So the shark teeth are going to disappear. Yeah, the shark teeth, these are going to disappear. I just did it for a meme when I was making the character. I saw that you could sharpen the teeth, and I was like, yo. And obviously, I turned off the mouth movement for it because, the bottom jaw was actually clipping through the skin, and it looked stupid. It looked even stupider than the base teeth. So, that's where we're at, folks. I'm making a 2D model, because I can, through GIMP, which is basically Photoshop for free. So I can do outlines of stuff, I can color it in, and I can make assets, layers, they call it. I can make layers, so like the upper teeth is a layer, the tongue is a layer, the iris, the pupil are layers. The shine off the eyeball is a layer, the white of the eye is a layer, the eyebrows are a layer, the eyelashes are a layer. And the eyeliner is a layer. All of those are layers right there. The nose is also a layer. Upper lip, lower lip. What else? Hair is an entirely different layer. And then you have the base face, which in my case is like a teardrop upside down, with ears attached to the side. That's the basic shape of it. So I'm taking pictures of stuff. Stuff that I like the shapes of, and I am coloring over those shapes. I am making the outlines of it and coloring it. And then I am removing those objects, and what I have left is a colored shape. And what I do with that shape then, in theory, mind you, this is all theory. It's all thought up in the shower. And I hooped and hollered, and my sister was like, you know I can hear all that noise you're making in the shower, right? And I'm like, whoops. I didn't disturb your, watching Doctor Who. So anyway, I can create assets, and I took pictures of this model that I can actually, like, chop up at each joint and sew back together as a 2D model. Because this is a 3D model, you can actually, let me see if I can. So you can see I can move it around, and, like, my head disappears. But, like, there's so much to the model, yeah. And, was it Alt? Yeah. So, yeah, it's a 3D model. It's a 3D model, which is really cool. But, let me see if I can walk. Look alright. It looks alright. But I think other VTubers don't take me seriously. Because I'm using literally a free model with free modeling software. So my solution is to make a free model, but make it look like I paid $1,000 for it. Never see me coming, and they'll never see you coming either, friends. Go get them. Go get them this weekend, and go get them next week, and you will find another video that is primarily triggers with a very short vocal introduction. Basically, hi, I'm Brescia. This is ASMR. Let's go. Let's freaking go. That's basically the only intro I do for those, and then it's just triggers all the time. So you'll find a trigger intensive video on Monday.